So, dear students, yesterday we were on the last part of the chapter of the play If I Were You. Okay. So, in this we came to know that when Gerard, he knew the intention of intruder and he wanted to save his life. What did he do? He made a false story to save himself and capture the intruder. Okay. So what kind of story was made by him? The story that he made, that he told him that not to kill him. Okay. And what false story was made by him? He told him that he too was wanted by the police. Okay. So by giving what example he made it clear, and he told him that he was living in isolation. He was also being chased by police. Police was also after him. So that's why he was living in a remote area in a cottage. Okay. So afterwards, what happened? What happened afterwards? At first, intruder couldn't believe. He was not easily, you can say, falling into the trap of that person. Okay. But all the decorative items, all the materials for appearance which were kept there, so because of that he had to trust his word. Okay. So therefore, what did he decide? He decided that instead of running from there alone, he should run away with Gerard in his car. Okay. So when they both were ready to move, so what smart work did he do? Gerard pushed him into the cupboard instead of going into a garage. And then he called his friends and asked him to send the cops, to send the police at his home. So in this way, very smartly, he made a false story. Okay, he made him to trust. Okay, and after that, when he was completely, in his trap, he really completely trusted him. So after that, what was done? So he, instead of going in garage, he pushed him into the cupboard. Okay, so in this way, Gerard handled the situation so smartly, so wisely, using his wisdom, using his smartness. Okay, now let's discuss the question answer. At last, a sympathetic audience. Who says this? Type your answer in chat box. At last, a sympathetic audience. Who spoke this dialogue? By whom this dialogue was spoken? Yes, very good, Dhiren Mahajan. This dialogue was spoken by Gerard. Okay. Why does he say it? What was the reason? Yes, type your answer in chat box. Yes, he says it because intruder told him, intruder asked him to talk about, to tell about himself. Is he a sarcastic or serious? From the dialogues that you have gone through, what can you tell? That it was sarcastic or it was serious? Yes, he was very much serious. So the audience, that is the intruder, was in no way sympathetic. Yes. Because when he was talking to Gerard, he was talking to him at a gunpoint. Okay. He was telling him to talk about himself so that he could use the information to further his own interest. Okay. Okay. Now next question we have is, why does the intruder choose Gerard as the man whose identity he wants to take on? Why has he chosen Gerard? So who is going to tell me this answer? Raise your hands. Okay, Dhiren, very good.
Ma'am, can I speak?
Yes, Dhiren, you speak your answer.
Ma'am, the intruder chooses Gerard as a man who whose identity wants us to take on, as Gerard lives in a small cottage which is quite away from the city. It's in the woods and forest, and here the no police or no cops will come to take him to the prison. Moreover, Gerard is the only man living in the cottage, and his the cottage is quite dull and looking poor, so no one would think that the intruder is here.
Very good, perfect answer. Okay, so that's why this was the reason that he chose that person, that whose identity he could use, because he was living in a very remote area. He was living in a cottage. Okay, he was living alone and he was not meeting different kind of people there. He was living aloof. So this was the reason, and he thought that he should use his identity. Okay, next question we have is, I said it with bullets. Who says this? Type your answer in chat box. Who says this? I said it with bullets. So this answer was, this question was spoken by Girard. What does it mean? I said it with bullets. It means he shooted someone. Yes. When things were going wrong, so he shooted someone. Is it the truth? Is it the truth? No, it was not the truth. What is the speaker's reason for saying this? See, this dialogue was spoken by Girard because he wanted that intruder should believe on his words. Okay, intruder should believe. Yes, Girard was also very dangerous. Okay, so intruder should not kill him. So that's why he had to tell a lie. He had to tell a lie that he has also killed someone. He's also escaped from the police because he wanted to save his life. So that's why he added this thing also, that cop is also after him. He made this plan because he wanted to save his life. Clear? He made this because he wanted to save his life. So who is going to tell me this fourth answer? Yes. Who is going to tell me fourth answer? Only one student is raising hand. What about others? Yes, Renuka, you tell me this answer. Fourth one. Sorry, third one. Is it the truth? Was the what is the speaker's reason for saying this? Tell me this answer. It was truth or not? It was not truth. It was a false. It was a cooked story. Okay, it was a cooked story which was made by Girard in order to save his life. Clear? What is Girard's profession called the parts of the play that support your answer? Okay. See, it is not given crystal clear that what was his profession, but from his dialogues, from his conversation, way of talking, we can very much imagine that he could have been a theatrical artist, perhaps a playwright. Okay. Because in different kind of parts of the play, he had spoken this dialogue that he had something to do with theater. Clear? Because in whole of the play, if you go through it again and again, you'll find out several parts of the play in which he had something to do with theater. Okay? And when he saw the intruder, he said, "This is all very melodramatic, not very original." And when the intruder asked him to talk about himself, he said, "At last, a sympathetic audience." So when the intruder asked him to talk about himself, he said, "At last, a sympathetic audience." He also spoke that dialect that, "Are you American or is that merely a clever imitation?" So when the intruder had told him his plans of killing him and to steal his identity, what was the dialogue spoken by him? You have to copy that dialogue as it is. That in most of the melodrama, villains is foolish enough to delay his killing long enough to be frustrated. And he again spoke like that. I said you were luckier than most melodramatic villains. So you have to pick up these lines from the drama and you have to write down. And when false identity was told to intruder in order to save himself. Okay. So what was spoken by him? That is a disguise outfit. False mustache and whatnot. Finally, after looking him up, he answered the phone and said that he can't send the props in times for rehearsal. He said that he was in a tough situation and may put in his next play. So you pick up all these points. With the help of these points, you frame your answer. Clear? In this way, you have to write down long answer. You will soon stop being smart. Who says this? You will stop being smart. Who says this? Yes. Very good. This was spoken by intruder to Gerard. And why does he say this? Why this dialogue was spoken? So intruder said this, Gerard was not anxious or upset at his breaking into his house. Because he was completing his words when the intruder stumbled. Okay? What according to the speaker will stop Gerard from being smart? What according to the speaker will stop Gerard from being smart? Because what was the intention of intruder? The intruder's intention was to kill Gerard and to take his identity. But according to intruder, Gerard would stop being smart when he would know what was going to happen to him. Yes. When Gerard would come to know about his, you can say, about the planning, what they were going to do with Gerard, this was the only way that afterwards Gerard would stop being over smart. Okay. They can't hang me twice. Who says this? They can't hang me twice. Who spoke this dialogue? Hurry up. They can't hang me.
Intruder says this.
Yes. This dialogue was spoken by intruder. And why does the intruder speak like this? Because he has already murdered one person. Okay. And if he would do another murder, it means he was saying that if he would murder Gerard, the police would not hang him twice. Okay. Next question. A mystery I propose to explain. What is the mystery the speaker proposes to explain? A mystery I propose to explain. What is the mystery the speaker proposed to explain? A mystery I propose to explain. A mystery I propose to explain. The mystery that Gerard proposed to explain was the story. The false story, the cook story that was framed by Gerard himself. What kind of story he framed himself? He framed that he was a criminal. He has committed murder. And now he has got away. And unfortunately, one of his person had been arrested. So that's why he was expecting some trouble that night. That's why he was ready to escape. Therefore, his bag was packed and he was ready to escape. Yes. So basically, the mystery was Gerard started explaining him that he himself was a criminal. He was just like an intruder. And when things were going wrong with him, he had committed a murder and got away. Yes, unfortunately, one of his men had been arrested and certain things were found which his men should have burned. So due to this thing, he was expecting that some trouble that night, and therefore he was packing his bag and he was ready to escape. Now, next question is, yes?
Ma'am, can you please explain the last line of the chapter? I'm not able to understand that.
Hello, yes, speaking. Sorry, I can't let you have the props in time for rehearsal. I would have had a spot for bother. Quite amusing. I think I will put it in my next play. Listen, can you tell your friend, the surgeon, to come up here? At once, you probably find him in the public bar. Okay. So this is the last scene when he was able to push. Wait. When he was able to push him in the cupboard. When he was able to push him in the cupboard. Okay. Because intruder was insisting him to let him come out of the cupboard. So Gerard, he did not become serious. In a very funny way, he spoke, yes, I don't want you to come out, to make you come out, because I would have a sport of bother. It means he was speaking in a very sarcastic way. Okay. And he was saying, no, I don't want to keep you out because you... sorry, I can't let you have the props in time for rehearsal. I would have a sport of bother. Quite amusing. I think I will put it in my next play. Okay. So in this way, sarcastic way, he was making fun of Gerard. Sorry, Gerard was making fun of intruder. Okay. And he was making fun of him, and he was saying that he would be putting it in his next play. Okay. Because he was saying that you tell our friend, the surgeon, who is surgeon? Police, to come up there so that police could come and arrest him. Okay. And after that, he said that afterwards, you will find him in the public bar. So Gerard, at the situation when intruder was in the cupboard and he was outside, when he was pleading him, he was making request to take him out. So Gerard was not serious at that time. He was also speaking in a very melodramatic way. He was also passing remarks to him. He was making fun of him. Okay. And he was telling him this thing. That you can find him in the public bar. So it was a sarcasm that he made. Okay. Now next question we have is, this is your big surprise. Where has this been said in the play? Okay. So this dialogue, this is your big surprise. This is your big surprise. This dialogue was spoken 2 times in the play. When was this spoken? It was spoken by intruder. Because when he told Gerard why he was there, what was the reason, what he was going to do with him. And on the second occasion, it was spoken by Gerard when he was about to reveal his cooked up story. A story which was made by him. Okay. And what is the surprise? So what was the surprise? The surprise was that the intruder was going to kill Gerard and take on his identity. So Gerard spoke this thing that surprise is that he was also a big criminal, like intruder. That if intruder is a big criminal, he was also a big criminal. So this was a surprise. Okay. Now thinking about language, let's do this. Okay, this thing, thinking about language, I'm going to give you this as a homework. You do this. Our college principal, PLE or PAL will come. You should know about this thing, PAL will come. So, bache, you do practice of this language. So, whole of the chapter is full with any examples. So, what is any basically? Any is when we say one thing but mean another. It means what we are saying, but we are, the meaning is actually opposite. Okay? It means whatever the dialect which was spoken, but the meaning is different. Okay? So suppose when someone is making a mistake and you say, oh, that was clever. It means you are saying clever, but it doesn't mean that the second person is really clever. So you want to say not clever. It means whatever you are saying, but its meaning is different. So this whole of the drama is full of different kind of expressions, which are full of irony. Okay. So you have to pick up these examples and you have to tell that what is spoken by narrator, what is written in the drama, and actually what is its actual mean. What is its actual meaning? Okay. Oh, that was clever. That is the irony. You are saying clever to mean not clever, like this. Oh, wasn't that clever? Oh, that was clever. Okay. Suppose the dialect is, you have been a great help, I must say. You have got yourself into a lovely mess, haven't you? Oh, very funny. How funny. So these all are dialects which show the very good examples of irony. Okay. Now you just go through the play carefully and you tell different kind of words or different kind of expressions which are used by Gerard in a very ironic way. And afterwards you pick up these examples and tell why, what is the meaning of these dialects. Some of the examples are given in front of you. Why? This is a surprise, mister. See, internally he was in panic. He was completely afraid. Okay? He was afraid, completely afraid. He was in panic. But the way he speaks, it seems that he was not in panic. He was completely confident. And he was not bothered about that intruder visit. Because when the author says, why, this is a surprise, mister. So he pretends that the intruder is a social visitor. And he is welcoming that social visitor. In this way, he was hiding his fear. At last, a sympathetic audience. He pretends that the intruder wants to listen to him. Whereas actually the intruder wants to find out information for his own use. Okay, so it was only pretendance. It was only show off that intruder was listening to him. So we have to pick up any another example. You type in chat box or you can raise your hand. Suppose there is one dialogue given. You won't kill me for a very good reason. So when he spoke like that, you won't kill me for a very good reason. What is the meaning of that line? Tell me, you won't kill me for a very good reason. You won't kill me for a very big reason, for a very good reason. So it means Gerard was only pretending, he was only showing off to have a very good reason. But actually, there was no such reason. Actually, there was no such reasons. So when the author was saying this dialogue, you won't kill me for a very good reason, it means Gerard was only pretending, he was only doing show off. However, there was no such reason. And in the very beginning of the play, there one dialogue is given that is a very good example of irony. Here example is given. In most melodrama, in most melodramas, the villain is foolish enough to delay his killing long enough to be frustrated. You are much luckier. It means the villain takes too long a time to make the killing and ends up being the wrong end. But intruder has been quite smart and lucky for not killing Gerard and taking away his identity. So when Gerard was telling him this cooked up story, the intruder turns out to be like the foolish villain of most melodramas. And very last line is also a very good example of irony. Last line of the play. Sorry, I can't let you have props in time for rehearsal. I would have a sport to bother quite as you mean. So the sport of brother that Gerard found quite amusing was actually, it is a life-threatening situation. This scene is compared to a life-threatening situation. Okay? Because he was being held at gunpoint, okay, by a murderer, and he wanted to kill him and he wanted to take his identity. But now the scene is different. And it was actually a life-threatening situation. So this is a best example of irony. Okay, bachche? So now you have to find out more and more examples of irony from this chapter. Only some of the extra questions are left. We will be doing these questions in detail tomorrow, and tomorrow your syllabus will come to an end after doing the discussion of some of the more important questions. Okay, I will be giving you from my side and we will be discussing all these questions in class. Okay, students.